So, Merry Christmas again!
Merry Christmas!
See, I was expecting this size crowd this morning. Yeah, I know how it goes. But we're going to be here to give God praise just the same.
Amen.
So, introduction of this morning's message. We're going to be talking about what child is this? Yeah, something spectacular happened. What child is this? Now, the birth of Jesus was foretold a long, long time ago before it happened. Long, long time. The prophet Isaiah, he prophesied that Jesus was going to be born a couple hundred years before they thought about it. Yeah, so God gave him that knowledge. And many people who did not believe that it was going to come to pass, they thought Isaiah was kind of a looney tune, you know. They didn't think he knew what he was saying. Because think about it. This man said something was going to happen. And a couple of hundred years after he was gone, it still didn't happen. So everybody was, yeah, you remember that one guy that told us that about this time a baby shall be? Oh yeah, I heard that story. So that's what was happening. Everybody said, you know, this could not come to pass. But the birth was very special. There was something special about this baby. So you have many people asking many questions. People want answers, you know. What is so special about this baby? What happened? So I picked a few of them, not a lot, just a few, right? About what child is this? And one of the first one that I want us to look on this morning is, he was not an ordinary child. Yes, he was not an ordinary child. Luke 1, 34 to 35. Look at this. Then Mary said to the angel, how can this be since I do not know a man? Right? And the angel answered and said to her, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the highest will overshadow you. Therefore also, that Holy One is to be born will be called the Son of God. I don't know about you, but Mary must have been scared out of her mind. Think about it. An angel came to you and said, you're going to be pregnant. And she's like, okay. First thing in her head, I'm going to hit Joseph with that hammer. He should have known better. But the angel was like, no, it's not Joseph. And then she's going to be like, then how is this possible? Think on that. That's a human statement right there. How is this possible? And the angel had to explain to her, this was going to happen. So think about it. This was no ordinary child. He didn't just come through natural means, as some people like to say. He came through a divine means. He did not come the natural way. He came by the Holy Spirit, choosing someone to deliver him. He was not an ordinary child. His birth was miraculous. It wasn't tainted by any human DNA, because as much as we don't want to say it, but in generations, you are, even though the mother carries you, but your genealogy is tracked through your father. That's crazy. God must have known this before, that this was how mankind would think. So, his genealogy had to be tracked back to who? God. God the Father. That's why it couldn't be done any other way. So, one, he was not an ordinary child. Secondly, this child was a savior. Look at this. In Matthew 1, verse 21, and she will bring forth a son, And you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Wow. I don't know about you, but if I was Joseph in that time, you know, I don't even know. What would Joseph say to Jesus, you know? You know, don't walk there. Don't trip over that. I can't afford for anything to happen to you. Because if you die, you die before your time. When he has a cold, he might be saying, oh my gosh, is he going to die? You know, he would be just on edge because he knew he had the Savior of the world in his hands. Mary would be the same thing. You think mothers are overprotective? Think on Mary going through all of this. One day, this man is going to save not only the people, but the world from their sins. This is an awesome responsibility. But apart from being not an ordinary child, he was definitely our Savior. Because if he wasn't born, then there'd be no death. So he was a Savior. He was actually born to redeem us back to God. Wow. So he wasn't an ordinary child, right? And he was a Savior. Third and finally, this child was God. What? Yes, let's look at this. Matthew 1, verse 23. Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel. And they went on to tell you what it means, so you didn't have to look it up, which is translated God with us. Wow. God with us. God sent his son to be with us in human form. That is so powerful. Right? This child was not just an ordinary child. This child was not also our Savior, but he was also God. That means he could have said, you know what? I don't think they deserve this. Let me talk to you, God the Father. Let's have a little powwow about this thing here, because I don't think they deserve this salvation. And remember, if you would read the scripture, he prayed about it. That was his human form kicking in right there. Like, you sure you want to do this for them? But then, the spiritual side said, not my will, but thine be done. He was God. He gave back lives to individuals that were dead. Remember, Lazarus was dead. And people say, if you were earlier, Lord. And he's like, Lucy, come forth, Lazarus. Think on that. The dumb, the deaf, the blind, all of them. Spirits, demons, when they saw him, they got covered, they got scared and said, don't destroy us. He was God. And he was acknowledged as God. But at the same time, you have others who did not acknowledge him as God. And they crucified him. But if that didn't happen, then his blood would have not been shed. So, the virgin birth is very important. It's something that we cannot go around. People try to tiptoe around it in Christmas time and try to explain it some other way. But the virgin birth is essential to what we believe in. Because if we don't have a virgin birth, then he came through the lineage of a man and not God, then he's no more our Savior. That's the whole reason for canceling that. That's the reason for canceling the virgin birth. Because what people need to realize is that the DNA of Jesus Christ came from the Heavenly Father. That's it. We have to remember that. That his DNA is not of this earth. Now I watched this documentary. Don't know if it's true. I didn't produce it. I watched it. Now there were some guys that did a study and they said they found the tomb where Jesus was buried. It should be on YouTube too, so you can look it up. And they said, yes, this is it, according to all the maps and everything, this is the tomb where he was buried. They have video footage too. And they went in there, and they found the cloth still wrapped up. As I said, I didn't produce it, it's there. And they said, well, there was blood stains in it. So they went in the tomb and they said, now we can prove to you which DNA or which background he came from, because you didn't have modern technology at this time. So they were here to clarify the myth. I love God, because God is always in control. So they went and they took the cloth and they took it to the lab. They did their analysis. And they did their analysis, and they did their analysis, and they, so people were like, it doesn't take that long to test blood. And they came back and they said, well, the report is inconclusive. So everybody said, what do you mean it's inconclusive? Well, when we tested the blood on the cloth that was folded right there, there is no other DNA in the world that matches it. It is a strand that we have never seen before. It could not possibly be human. But at the same time, it has all characteristics of being human. But there is none ever discovered in the world that has that and a trait like that. No other human has ever seen that. This is the scientist talking, not me. Now, I was glad. When God does his things, he looked through the ages of time and saw what was going to happen. He knew science was going to get to the place where they think they can prove everything wrong or right. So when he does something, he does it properly. Amen?
Amen.
So the Christmas story is not a myth. Not a myth whatsoever. It is not a tale like Santa Claus for us just to feel good. The Christmas story is a reality. If we do not believe or accept this reality, then we are doomed. That's the thing. Our Christian faith hangs on the very birth. If we do not embrace Christ's birth as a reality, then we have not embraced Christ at all. That's how simple it is. Always remember, he came as a human baby to grow and die just for you and me, that we might be free from sin. So whenever it's Christmas time, remember that special child that was born years ago. Amen?
Amen.
Let us look to the Lord in prayer. Eternal God and most righteous Father,